Hey foodies, welcome back to our channel guys. So, are you one of those people who love fish? Do you enjoy eating the naughty recipes in fish? So, I have a few friends who are crazy about fish. So, I would like to dedicate this recipe to some of my close friends who love fish. So, here is our version of naughty fish curry. So, if you like it, please continue watching. So today we'll be showing you a different variety of fish curry guys. This is our village style fish curry. So these are the ingredients that we'll need to make this. So let's see what we'll need. I've taken some fish here, onion, green chilies, garlic, ginger, some raw coconut, some spices I've taken over here, salt, cinnamon and cloves also known as chakka and lavanga, some mustard seeds, some methi seeds and some turmeric. I've also taken some more onions for like the tadka part of it, dhania powder, a lemon-sized tamarind soaked in hot water, some coriander, and curry leaves. We've also taken some oil here, guys. So let's get started. Light up the stove and add about 4 to 5 teaspoons of oil. To this oil, I'm adding about 1 teaspoon of methi seeds. Be sure to add only 1 teaspoon. If you add more than that, your recipe will become really bitter here, guys. After that, I'm going to add in 3 medium-sized onions that I have sliced up. I'm going to give this a good fry. To this, I'm going to add in about 12 to 15 green chilies. If you don't like green chilies, you can add in red chili powder instead. And if you're a chili lightweight, you can adjust the spice according to your taste requirements. Once these have tossed in the heat for a while, to this I'm gonna add in 1 handful of garlic and about 3 inches of ginger. Now the reason why we're frying these masala items is because our fish doesn't take much time to cook, guys. So if you don't fry this beforehand, the masala will taste raw, the curry will have a raw taste. So to avoid that, we're going to do this. Now take some cinnamon and cloves. I've taken about 4 to 5 cloves and about 1 to 2 inches of cinnamon. Also adding about 1 cup of raw coconut that I have sliced up nicely. To this, adding in tamarind. This tamarind is 1 lemon sized. This is what gives a good flavor guys, a naughty flavor. And also adding in about 1 cup of coriander. Now, whatever mixture that we had cooked earlier, the onions, green chilies, garlic and ginger, once it has cooled down a little bit, add that. Also, I'm adding about 4 tablespoons of dhania powder. Don't go heavier than this guys, it won't taste that great. To this, add about 50 ml of water and give this a good grind and let it form a smooth paste like this. Now, keep a big vessel and let's get started. I'm adding about 5 to 6 tablespoons of oil to this. And once the oil heats up, I'm going to add in about 2 teaspoons of mustard seeds. Let the seeds pop so that they can release their nice aroma and flavor into your dishes. Once that's done, I'm adding about 3 to 4 strands of curry leaves here. After about 10 to 15 seconds, the onion that we had taken earlier for the tadka, I am adding that in. 1 medium sized onion, roughly chopped. Also, I am adding about 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric, guys. Try to use turmeric as much as you can because turmeric is really healthy. It has a lot of health benefits. One of the main one includes preventing cancer. So try to use that. Now, whatever paste we had just made, add that in. It's really simple to make this. So I hope you give this a try, guys. Now keep the flame on low and let the masala cook. You want the masala to cook for a while before you can add in the fish. I'm also adding about 500 to 600 ml of water into this. And I'm going to cook this on low flame for about 15 to 20 minutes. Add salt according to your taste requirement, guys. Check for taste and let the masala cook well. After about 15 to 20 minutes, it should look something like this. Now I've taken about 2 kgs of fish here. This fish, I have washed it with lemon and turmeric and have set aside. I'm going to add this in once the masala has cooked well for 15 to 20 minutes. Once you add in the fish, it should not cook for more than 5 to 7 minutes, guys. If you cook your fish for more than 7 to 8 minutes, you'll be overcooking your fish and that will not taste good at all. So all of you who cook fish, you'll know this. But if you're new and you want to try this recipe for the first time, please keep this in mind. So let's cook this for 5 to 7 minutes and then check in later if the fish has cooked well. As you see, the fish is nicely cooked. So we'll turn off the heat, guys, and I'm going to serve it into a bowl. This recipe tastes great with ragi mudde. It tastes amazing with rice. Also tastes really good with chapati and puri. So I hope you guys like what we're showing for you guys. If you like our videos, click the like button and please consider subscribing to our channel, guys. I'm sure you'll love what we're showing.